NASA's James Webb Space Telescope is cooling down for its next trick. Observing the universe, the telescope's chief scientist discussed its nearly 40 days in space so far. It's been a whirlwind 38 days in space for the James Webb Space Telescope, but its chief scientist says the mission is well on track to uncover the universe soon. The telescope is cold, the instruments are cooling. John Mather, a Nobel laureate and astrophysicist who also works at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, said during a live-streamed Explore Mars event Thursday, February 3. Webb needs to be very cold for its infrared instruments to pick up subtleties in galaxies, exoplanets and other objects it is examining, and Mather said individual photons, particles of light, are starting to register in the telescope's detectors. No images to show you yet, he said, but it will be soon, I hope. In about 5 more months, Webb will begin an ambitious science program covering all aspects of astrophysics, but it must pass a rigorous commissioning period first, he noted. Right now, a key activity is aligning the 18 hexagonal elements of the primary mirror. For the time being, they are working as 18 separate telescopes, but will soon need to act as a single mirror looking at the deep universe, Mather explained. First, we have to find the images that all of those 18 different hexagons are making, then figure out which one is which, and then start sending commands to the little motors that move the viewers around to get them in the right place, he said. Then surely, we get them lined up so they do a nice sharp image with a near-infrared camera. Then we have to check that the other three instruments are also in focus. One of the instruments isn't even turned on yet, the mid-infrared instrument, so the process hasn't started yet. It will be ready about 4 months after the December 25th launch, while the others should be available 2 months post-launch. Then we're ready to start announcing our first results around the summer solstice next year, Mather said. Mather said the images Webb produces, since they are largely in infrared, will be different than what we are used to with the long-running Hubble Space Telescope that uses different infrared wavelengths, along with visible light. We can see into and through the dust clouds using infrared because the infrared will go around the grains instead of bouncing off, Mather explained. So in other words, Webb will be able to peer deep into dust clouds where exoplanets are forming, or to look at the hearts of dust-filled galaxies. It will still be beautiful pictures, but it'll be different, he noted. Closer to home, he promised Webb will turn its attention to solar system objects like Mars or Jupiter's moon Europa, which are targets of more robotic exploration in the 2030s and beyond. Webb will also bring some attention to Earth-sized planets orbiting M-dwarf stars, which may be habitable depending on the radiation environment. In seeking life in distant areas of the universe, Webb will not be able to give definitive answers but can give us some pointers, Mather said during the question and answer period. We do not expect to see oxygen with this observatory, it's too hard, he said of looking at Earth-sized planets for signs of life. We are not looking at the correct wavelength to be able to do it. But we do expect to be seeing presence of water vapor in little planets' atmospheres. Webb may also be able to assist with dating stars and globular clusters, Mather said in response to another question, that would help us with understanding stellar ages and the evolution of the universe at large. Examples of other forthcoming investigations he pointed to included looking at young solar systems in nebulas or gas clouds, and using supernovas to assess the expansion rate of the universe. Observing the universe the way humans have observed the universe has developed throughout history. At first, the only information available was what could be observed by eye. The invention of the telescope meant that much more detailed observations could be made, and it became possible to see objects much further away. Modern increases in the size and sensitivity of telescopes have meant that observations can be made to incredible distances and the very faintest of stars. Invisible observations. Modern technology can be made sensitive to electromagnetic frequencies that human eyes cannot sense. This has opened up areas of astronomy that were not available previously. Observing the radio waves or infrared or X-ray emissions from stars and galaxies has allowed scientists to make a huge number of discoveries in a very short time. Space telescopes. Many of the extra wavelengths of M-waves that astronomers would like to observe do not penetrate the atmosphere. This means that any telescope which is to use these parts of the M spectrum, such as most ultraviolet light, needs to be based on a satellite above the atmosphere. The Hubble Space Telescope has detectors for visible light and also for infrared and ultraviolet. Theories of the universe. The Big Bang theory of the universe. According to the Big Bang theory, about 13.8 billion years ago, the whole universe was a very small, extremely hot and dense region. From this tiny point, the whole universe expanded outwards to what exists today. Evidence from redshift astronomers have discovered that, in general, the further away a galaxy is, the more redshifted its light is. This means that the further away the galaxies are, the faster they are moving. This is similar to an explosion, where the bits moving fastest travel furthest from the explosion. Redshift data provides evidence that the universe, including space itself, is expanding. Evidence from CMBR astronomers have also discovered a cosmic microwave background radiation, CMBR. This comes from all directions in space and has a temperature of about minus 270 degrees Celsius. The CMBR is the remains of the thermal energy from the Big Bang, spread thinly across the whole universe. The discovery of the CMBR, after it had been predicted by the theory, provided very strong support for the Big Bang theory, and led to the Big Bang becoming the currently accepted model of the development of the universe.
Well guys, this video is over. I hope you enjoy. If you enjoy, be sure to hit the like button. Actually, I'm sick and I couldn't record this video with my own voice. So, accept my apologies. And until the next video, have a great time.